Presidente Robson, qual o maior risco que corremos, né, na COP 26, em relação ao que essas empresas têm buscado? Qual o maior risco que a justiça climática corre em não ser implementada todas as questões que vão ser colocadas lá, mas principalmente as modificações às quais elas estão sujeitas? Para você, qual o maior risco?
I think the major risk in COP26 will be a sort of breakdown of trust between those countries most affected by climate change, speaking about climate justice and not seeing a commitment of the big emitters. And the big emitters are the historic emitters, but also the large emerging countries, the G20. If they don't, step up much more than they've done, and they do it in Rome before COP, then I can see a problem of trust really at the conference. And then with that, the production gap that the UN Environment Programme published yesterday, is scary because it's saying every government is going to increase its production. Every significant government, including the US, is going to increase its oil and gas and maybe reduce coal, and the UK is reducing coal. But, the International Energy Agency has made it quite clear there should be no new exploration of coal in particular, but also no new exploration of oil and gas. That's what the International Energy Agency has said, which used to be quite conservative and supportive of fossil fuel in the past, because they read the science and they understand. So, any, I think, it's going to be difficult at the COP to manage expectations, but also to politically ensure that we are on track to a 1.5 degree world. The elders, I can tell you, we will be doing our utmost to keep that focus, keep that attention, and keep saying if the COP in Glasgow is aligned to 1.5, I don't mean already on course to achieve it, but I mean it's within reach because a process. What I mean is, in the Paris Agreement, it was agreed that countries would increase their ambition every 5 years. What we're saying is no. Countries that need to increase their ambition must do it every year. The countries that should be giving more in finance must do it every year, not every 5 years. And we must have a sort of pathway that accelerates because of